Hey, Jamie, this one's for you. Jamie Canfield, calling you out. We're getting down to it. She's snug undercover, and she's in really good hands. The golden ball. Hi there.
How are you?
Good. I'm just taking a few pictures here to
you do your thing.
Let everybody know we've got a thread on Wooden Boat magazine we're gonna post this to. You wanna say hi to the Wooden Boat people?
Hello, Wooden Boat people.
And give you your name?
My name's Jason.
Jason, and he came down with Brian Kennedy, who we just filmed up on the bow, to work on the golden ball. They've mapped every plank in this hull and they know exactly what they're gonna replace. And I'm gonna take some quick pictures. They're doing some work on, what do you call this right here? The keel, something or other?
That's the keel.
But there's a certain part of it.
That's the stem doing it.
This keel stem, that's what I couldn't remember the name of, yeah. They're doing some work on that, and they've got some wood over here, and it smells wonderful in here. It smells like linseed oil. They've been treating this live oak. Look at that beautiful wood. That's amazing. Huge slabs to work from. Here's my hand in it so you can see how big these slabs are. They're immense. I'm visualizing the tree these came out of and how old it must have been. And these will go into the golden ball. So she's got a nice little snug place here in Apalachicola, in the Apalachicola Maritime Museum's work area. They came in and built up this site a little bit, put a nice bed of shells down, and got her all propped up good. And this is a new acquisition, but we're going to save this one for another video. And this is George. He's from...
George Boswellcott. I learned how to build boats in New England. I lived on Cape Cod for about 15 years.
So you're down here helping just on this project? You're helping...
Well, I actually moved. I retired down here in Florida, and I came to the museum last weekend just to get my hat for joining the membership, and George hired me on the spot. So, voila. We have a multi-year commitment.
Fantastic, George. Welcome aboard.
I'm glad to be aboard.
Just using that to mold another piece out of.
Yeah, I was just show how massive that is. I was trying to get my hand in it to get perspective before, and it's just
sure. I mean, look.
I know. I mean, it's just the grain tells you that.
Oh, sure, and the fact that these were even trimmed indicates the size of the original tree. I mean, it's really they're just massive. And what I was going to offer you to do is try and just pick this up a little bit. Here, I'll film you do it.
It's on.
It's like a piece of iron.
Yeah,
it's a piece
is.
Of steel. Yeah. And same thing, even trying to...
I could not pick this up and move it if I tried.
Well, and even trying to cut it with a chainsaw, with a sharp chainsaw, was really a challenge.
Yeah. Yeah,
but it's good. It's good stuff. But we've
incredibly
got
dense.
Incredibly dense. But we've got some good grain on this. We have some pieces that have some great natural curve to mm-hmm. work on that stem and the forekeel. We've just got good pieces to do pretty much everything.
Where did it come from? Do you know, George?
It came from somewhere in South Georgia. I want to say Thomasville, plantation country, but just somewhere in South Georgia.
We'll ask George about that. I'm sure he knows.
Here in Live Oak.
Yeah, there's the very center. You can see the center of the heartwood right there. That's amazing.
Isn't that something?
Oh, my God.
And we've got it a little bit darker like this, too.
Yeah, because the linseed.
The linseed and the...
it really brings out the grain, though. I mean, God, that's beautiful, that grain in it.
Isn't that something?
Yeah, amazing.
So we have good materials to finish the boat.
Yep.
We're really top-notch, first-class material.
Can you imagine what this boat must weigh? I know that the guy that delivered it here told me.
Well,
but
I mean, these are each like 2x4s. So
I know.
You can imagine just the weight of everything here.
Yeah.
But yeah, everything's big.
And since you're talking, why don't you tell, I covered it in other videos, but why don't you say, George, a little bit about the the history of this boat and the design and the Herreshoff design?
Well, it's a Herreshoff, an L. Francis Herreshoff design. But I'm almost sweaty.
That's okay.
But it was built up in the 60s, 62, and it was actually built up in Pocasset, Massachusetts, mm-hmm. for a Herreshoff actually designed it for a client in West Florida, down, I believe, in the Naples, somewhere down in southwest Florida.
So
where you have a little more shallow waters. And it was designed by Herreshoff because this client wanted to take parties out, whether they were charter parties or just, you know, weekend have fun parties, I'm not really sure. But it's just had a pretty busy life.
And it's got the special...
it has leeboards. It's got a big lead shoe down along the bottom. And so it only draws about 2 feet, which is perfect mm-hmm. for these bays and shallow areas we have around here. And it's got some leeboards, and here's some of the hardware that attaches the leeboard.
Yeah. Leeboard. Huge. They're really big.
Leeboard's a big board that'll come down like this. And these apparently have some sort of mechanism that I think even allow them to angle out and to adjust the angle on it.
Mm-hmm.
So it's really, it's a big cavernous boat, but it's really very nice. It's perfect if you're bringing a lot of people out in the water.
Right, very stable. And
Yeah.
Great.
Good boat.
Good. Well, I've got some stills on my computer that I'll include in this of what it looks like when Jamie had it fully restored before, and I'll include that.
Do you have something on there too about what it actually looked like and some of the other
yes,
shots?
Yes, I have some
like
of those shots, yeah, good. From Jamie.
That ain't nothing. That's just a little outside piece, isn't it?
Well, I
strapped
it off. I saw this part off.
Right.
This is
the
problem. This
one? Oh, yeah, further up in there. Oh, yeah. That boat ain't holding on nothing. Unless it goes all the way through.
Gate open here.
Yep.
Right there, stop water.
Uh huh.
See that stop water there?
Right.
It's separated there.
So that thing is falling too.
And
then subsequently it was pushing that off.
You see, that's the original plank.
Right.
But I can stick my finger in that crack.
Kind of soft up in there somewhere, too, isn't it? Look.